Welcome back everyone. So let's talk more on JavaScript interview questions in this video. So first common questions I see people ask about the closure definition. What is the closure? Why it is needed in JavaScript and why it is helpful? How it is helpful? So the definition of closure is simple: function A returns a function B and function B can access the variable of function A. Thus function B is called a closure, because function B is inside function A and function B has access to the scope of function A. It means when you do the console.dir B, B is having the value of variable A, which is inside a function A, inside a closure. So when you do console.dir function B, you will see the closure entity there and you will see A equal to 1 stored there. So you should be good and clear what closure is, what are the different use cases, where it is being used. It's everywhere in JavaScript. Now this is the classic simple interview questions. What will be the output of this particular loop? Most of the time people misunderstood these questions and they in hurry they start writing the answer and they always end up writing the bad answer, right? Because here this is a synchronous loop and inside that you are running a synchronous code. So your I will reach to the value of 5, right? But your set timeout is still going to execute. In that case, you will get all the value is as 5. How can we fix this particular problem? There are different ways of fixing it and getting the correct value of I. Either you change the var to let. So let has a block level scoping. So we'll see one by one. So these are the two different variations of the solution. Either you just encapsulate this particular code in an if block, immediate invoking block, where you are passing the j in each and every iterations and you are getting the value properly. Because here I'm passing, so in the if block I'm passing this value of I, whatever I'm getting in the iterations, and that is being used inside a set timeout. Solution 2, replace the var keyword with the let. There may be other solutions, but I'm just talking about these two solutions. Now you will get a value 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This diagram is, I just got it from the Wikipedia. This diagram is saying a lot about JavaScript. I may be having one separate webinar about the prototype and prototype of a functions and proto of an object. Whenever we are actually inheriting the prototype of function A into the B, how the linking is happening. Whenever you are assigning the object B into the A, then how the proto-linking is happening. So you need to understand the prototypal inheritance. You need to understand how the proto actually links with the prototype of a function. So you can see whenever you create a function, function has a two things, a prototype and a constructor. So constructor will help a functions to create an object and prototypes will help to link it with another object or another function, right? So whenever you create a new foo of these functions, so there is a proto link because you have created an object and object has a proto link with the prototype. Okay, so whenever you are actually, so this is the function object. Object is a master function in JavaScript. It has a prototype and a constructor, right? So functions is a root function whose proto points to the null. So if you try to create an object of a functions, then do a .proto, 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 .proto. It will go until the proto comes to the null, because proto will finally point to the object's proto, which is a master function. Okay, so you created an object. So if you remember, you can also create a JavaScript object equal to new object or object.create, right? So what new object is doing? It is creating the function. So you created a functions, right? This is the function definition. It has a prototype and a constructor. So constructor is pointing to the function, prototype is pointing to the object prototype. When you do dot underscore underscore proto, it is actually pointing to an object. Okay, so let's talk about simple function. Function. Its function prototype is actually pointing to the object proto. Okay, I'm talking about this chain. Function prototype. Now function prototype of proto is pointing to the object proto, and object proto is linked to the null. If you're not able to understand from here, I will give a separate session, because this is one of the important thing in a JavaScript, to understand the general functions, to understand the object function, and to understand the function. Then points to remember, what all different things we need to remember about regarding the __ proto and the prototype. Each function beside function.prototype.bind has an internal property denoted as a prototype, which is a reference of prototype. Each object has an internal property denoted as __ proto, which is a reference to the prototype of the constructor that created that object. If you understand this line, you understand what is a proto. So __ proto is a reference to the prototype of that constructor that created the object. So consider, I'm creating the function here, new object. So the proto of this object is pointing to the constructor of that function. You see, I did a new object or new foo, I've created the object, right? So the proto of this object is pointing to the prototype of the function which creates it. Object can use a proto to look up the properties that do not belong to the object. Consider an example, you have object A with a 3 property, object B with the and you created object B and assigned the object A. Now you added some more properties in object B. Now you assigned B to the C property. Now you are trying to access some property which is not there on the C object, but it will look up to that variable in the object B, object A, because there is a proto linking happened between C, B and A. So using __ proto, you try to connect and try to get the value from object B and object A. So that is called a prototype chain. So in the object, this is called a proto chain. In the functions, you are trying to get the value. So in same in the function A, function B, function C. Function A has a prototype which is inherited by the function B. Function B defined its own prototype method, then it is inherited by function C. But in function C, when you are trying to access some function or property, then it will check those values in the prototype chain. It will check in the C, it will check in the B, it will check in the A. So that is called the formation of prototype chain. And you should be aware of this, because this is one of the crucial or important questions in the JavaScript interview. How the inheritance works? Now the major question. So I have the super functions, I defined one prototype method onto it. Now I have a sub function and I created an object of the sub function, right? So I'm trying to inherit the prototype of the super into the sub. So you can see sub.prototype, but I'm passing object.create and I'm passing the super.prototype. Okay, so super.prototype is being inherited in the sub.prototype. There are different ways, either you can assign sub.prototype equal to super.prototype, or you can create isolated copy using object.create super.prototype, and these are the properties you are assigning. So in object.create, whenever you define, so this is like a property you are creating, and what are the property is enumerable is false, writable is, and configurable is true. It means you can update it. This is a configurable, this is the writable. So every object.define property has all these three properties, and here I'm inheriting the super.prototype in the sub.prototype. Okay. ES6 way of inheritance is a plain and simple. You are actually extending a particular class into another class. But this is a syntactic sugar. Actually, the things which are happening is dealing with the prototype only. Okay, so let's talk in the next video about more in-depth JavaScript interview questions about shallow copy and deep copy.